really self, different from ego, Freud emphasis. But I find Jung already find trouble. Jung also emphasize self. He just say, ego become self is very difficult, need great wisdom. This Jung says these words, need great wisdom, great understanding, then become self. But the Chinese philosophy steer this way, go to self. Then I find in psychology, beside Freud and Jung, some psychology already find human nature is good. It's like Maslow. I read his introduction. He said human nature is good. Evil just come from outside. He already said human being was born, have some goal. This goal, maybe his whole life rough. This is like a confused heaven destiny. He already touched, but I don't know he studied Chinese philosophy or not. Now, our school, some people call transpersonal psychology. I find transpersonal psychology, they go to this level. They study Indian, they practice meditation. But as they stay here, not go to here, not go to here. They regard meditation as a goal. Actually, no self, just principle. No self, just theory. No self, there's no self in it. So no self, ego, both are serious. So if you practice no self, you should go up. You cannot limit yourself in no self. Stugner here. You are expert of consciousness only school. Consciousness only school. Consciousness same. Talk about alias, the A's consciousness, same as unconsciousness, store. Store consciousness, right? Store consciousness, yeah. Then this is self. This is five senses and you are consciousness. But really conscious school emphasize transform consciousness into wisdom. Then become here is three wisdom. Here is last wisdom. It's a great mere, round mere wisdom. It's a Buddha nature, Buddha mind. But the consciousness in China, Xuanzang, his book have this, but his disciple, same as Jung and Freud, just here, wrong here. Forgot here. So here, very important wisdom. So, talk a conclusion. I don't want to talk a conclusion, my tea party already discussed. So I have two new book, Chinese book. Also in the concern mind tea party, the student or most of this psychology student as a Christian. Then I go home to do my homework to write the article. One student asked me humility, humble. Chinese student in China, in Taiwan, they are tradition teaching, tradition teaching is humble humility, they teach, father teaches them, okay. But come here, there's a trouble. If you are very humble, you cannot, if you have a question, the computer, all students have question. But the Chinese students are very humble. The teachers, this student, nothing. They do not study. So he asked me about humility. So humility from Chinese, going to psychology, how to deal with this? So I wrote an article. Another student, ICP student, Chen Ye, before he went to New York, he worried. San Francisco, you know, he know everything. New York is a new place. So he told me, my mind is not peaceful. I say, your mind not peaceful, you ask your teacher psychology help you. He said, no, they cannot help me. So he want Chinese philosopher help me. Help her. So okay, I go home to study. Then I find Chinese philosophy deal with something mind not peaceful. Zen Buddhism is very famous. The second patriarchal meet the first patriarchal, Bodhidharma. Bodhidharma asked, why you come here? The second patriarchal said, I'm not mind not peaceful. Then Bodhidharma said, give me your mind. So I cannot find my mic, already peaceful. This is very easy to solve problem. Zen Buddhism. Also, Confucius the same. Confucius once meet a trouble in Chencai, the priest. 1 week no food. Last student hungry, sickness. So one student is very rash, Zilu, complain. He said, Confucius, you emphasize supreme people. Supreme people, how can no food to eat? He complained. Then Confucius asked another two students about this situation, how to do. Ask Zigong, how to do. Zigong is a businessman. So go say, Confucius, your goal is too high. Your philosophy is too high. Cannot go into market. So you need to go down, communicate with people, easy to be accepted by other people. The businessman will do this. Then Zigong, Confucius asked Yan Hui is a virtue. Yan Hui said, don't worry, we keep our principle, no change. If they cannot accept their rules, none will lose. Confucius is very happy. I agree with you. So this Confucius deal with people's trouble, students complain, even minor peaceful, they have different way. Okay. So this Zen Buddhism, Confucius does the same. Deal with people. If people might have trouble, people. So like this article in this two book, diversity. I wrote article. When I get this title, my one student, Melanie. Suki asked her help description. He keep this title. Also, he give me another title. The another title is Chinese philosophy is a cultivation psychology related to contemporary American life. Oh, this is very beautiful. This is my first lecture, is this. I do not use this, I use this. Her title is good. This, if you read the paper in conference, good. Very clear. Too gentle. Too gentle. The psychology scholar say, okay, Chinese philosophy, psychology, you say this. I don't care. You say Confucius is a psychologist, is okay, it's, don't care. So this title, actually, I say on purpose, I'm very brief, on purpose, treat, T-R-E-A-D, treat the psychology. Well, open psychology. So some psychologists call them not happy. Okay, why I need a Chinese philosophy practice? From this, I think about one hexagram in Yi Jing. In Yi Jing. The hexagram name is a trade. 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 This trade. You trade. This only yang in line, the major line. This yang is very strong. So in this hexagram is when you trade the tail of a tiger, tiger will bite you. Okay, so this line is my position. This is Chinese philosophy. This is psychology. I want to trade the psychology's tail. It's danger. Danger. How to do? Okay. In this hexagram teacher, in this line is weak. You need to transform this to yang line energy to you. So make you not too weak. So this two yang line is like a Taoism, is like a Confucius. So when I say some words not very polite to Freud and Jung, but Zhuangzi helped me. This is Zhuangzi, not me. Okay. Then go to this line. I'm very cautious. Very cautious. This line teach you cautious. Cautious. So very cautious. So this yin line can treat on this yang line. Merge these two yang line. Go with this three yang line. So this Chinese philosophy merge with Western psychology. Okay, so in my opinion, in future, actually, we talk about psychology, we talk about philosophy, just we bound ourselves, we build a system. Actually, there's no system, no system. So psychology scholar could be a philosopher, philosophy also could be a psychology. No bounder. We should be very open. In future, psychology, not only consciousness, they have three ways they need to go. When I read all book, psychology, not all book, not so many. This is psychology book. This is Lenin, he worried, I don't know psychology. So he he gave me, let me read. Then when I read this book, I find psychology so far. Maybe some people difference. Not touch, qi. They only talk consciousness. They never discuss qi. Also, they never discuss virtue. They never discuss wisdom. So these three, qi, virtue, wisdom. Wisdom, maybe Buddhism, emphasize wisdom. Virtue, maybe Confucius, emphasize wisdom. Qi is Taoism. So these three parts, I think in future, if psychology have a very great development, should go in this way. Not just limit, not just use mask and arm for fighting. Okay, so we finish. Thank you. Thank you. We still have time. We take some food. We can discuss informally. Not I speak. Everybody can talk. Okay? We take a few minutes break.
on behalf of everyone here and on behalf of everyone who isn't here, everywhere, thank you very much.
Okay, thank you.
I'd like to have a picture with President and speaker.
Thank you, you're coming.
You have the wound?
Very nice. Okay.
Oh, just a minute.
Yeah, okay, thank you. Oh, yeah. okay.
Thank you.